Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you? I hope spectacular. We're going to do a little quick demo for you today based on a viewer email. If you have questions for me about technology and it makes a great demo, I'll do this. I'll create a little video based on your letter. And so, Rosalind, thank you because you asked me a great question that a lot of people have. She's setting up a new Gmail address or new Gmail account. And Rosalind says, could you tell me if it's possible to add all my contacts to my Gmail from my address book? And if so, how do I go about doing this? I like that question because it is not always self-evident how to move contacts from one address book to another. And in fact, quite often for a lot of people, the thought of moving their address book is terrifying. So they actually stay using a address book system or an email system that they really don't like using because they're afraid of migrating all of their contacts out of that into a new address book. It's not all that difficult. I wouldn't say it's, what would it be? Maybe 4 out of 10 on a technical scale, depending on what address book you're going from and going to. In this case, we're going to Google Contacts, which I think is a great way to go because it's so universal. So moving your contacts into Google Contacts, big thumbs up on that. Now, you didn't tell me what you're coming from, so I'm going to kind of walk you through a couple of different scenarios. The first is if you happen to be in the Apple world and you happen to be unfortunate enough to have used Apple's contacts for many years, and I know I shouldn't bash Apple, but I don't like their built-in productivity tools. I don't like their contacts. I don't like their calendar. And I don't like their email software. I find them all limiting. And the fact that they're given away for free and included with the operating system means that Apple has never really applied themselves to these tools the way that they've applied themselves to the rest of the world, to stuff they sell to us. So I wish they would apply themselves a little bit better, make them better. Okay. Off the soapbox, Steve, and on to how to export it. With Apple's address book, and with a lot of address books, you just go under the file menu, find export, and that will tell you immediately what your options are as far as exporting your contacts into another file. And Apple's very limited. You can create an archive, which is a backup, or you can export them as a vCard format, which is a virtual business card format, which is actually quite useful. But Apple's leaving out one big thing here is you can't export them as a CSV or comma separated value file, essentially a spreadsheet file. So you can't export it into a spreadsheet, which is too bad because if you want to clean up and you want to work and massage the data, in a spreadsheet is the best way to do that. So it's a limitation of Apple's address book. You'll have to take a look at your own address book and figure out what your options are for exporting it. But if you can export into vCard format, that's your best bet because it will import very cleanly into Google Contacts. Now the challenge is if it doesn't support vCard format and we have to export as a CSV, or we've got our email addresses already in a spreadsheet, or they're coming from a mail list that we've gathered. Maybe addresses are coming from a different place other than an address book. Then we have to make sure that we map the content, we map the data correctly against Google's format within their address book. I'm going to show you what I mean. So let's pretend that we've exported these vCards as a vCard format. And it's really easy to then import them into Google Contacts. We just navigate to Google Contacts in our browser. There we go under the More menu and we choose Import. And very limited, but covering off pretty much everything you need. It says right here, you can select a CSV, comma separated value spreadsheet, or a vCard and upload it. So all I would do is I would navigate to that file, choose import, and every time I've done this with vCards, it's been absolutely clean and pristine, and everything has mapped correctly. Now, this business of mapping correctly is something that you really need to understand because there's a lot of different data fields that Google has within their contacts. And so those are actual physical kind of locations within the field. vCard will map against those accurately, but if you've got a CSV file, you have to then mirror that mapping in your CSV file before you import it. Because if it's row 3 and you've got email address in row 3, but row 3 in Google Contacts is asking for a street address, well, you've got a problem because your email addresses are all going to go in the street address field and things aren't going to sort and they're not going to work properly. That's the issue we face. But there's a fairly easy workaround. It's just kind of a two-step process. And here it is. I'm going to walk you through it. And you will be amazed at how simple it is. What I do is I take a blank file out of Gmail. I'm going to select a file. And in this case here, this is just an empty demo record. But I choose that and I export it into the format that I want. I'm going to export it as a Google CSV format. So I'm going to export it. What this is going to give me is it's going to give me a template. It's going to give me a spreadsheet, a little spreadsheet file, but take a look at it when I open it. This is kind of magic. When I open it up, it opens up with all of the different fields listed out across the very top of the spreadsheet. So that all I have to do to copy records into it is in my spreadsheet, if I've got first name in my spreadsheet right there, I've got first name, last name. So I just select all of my first names from my spreadsheet. I'll just select a few of them there. I just copy them. And if I paste them into the given name field right there, they are all going to line up perfectly. And then I do their family name and I go on. And all I have to do is look at these major headings and make sure that I'm copying the data into the correct field. As you read through them. Actually, there's a few that confused me. I got to admit, as I was reading through, take a look at this one here. It's called Yummy Name. I didn't know what a yummy name was. I had to look it up. Do you know what a yummy name is? I didn't think so. A yummy name is the phonetic representation of a Chinese name, because it's written with different characters. So it's the phonetic representation. So they're recognizing the fact that this is not the real spelling, because that would involve characters as opposed to letters. There we go. We live and learn. At any rate, we look along here. We find email address. We import the email address. We import the street address. We import the phone number. We do all of that. Then once this is all said and done, we go back into our contact manager here within Gmail, or within Google Contacts, excuse me. We choose import. We navigate our way through to the file that we've just saved that was the template, but we've now copied all of the information into. We go import, and then we navigate our way through to it, and it will import your records accurately and correctly. It's the best way that I know of to import your records to import records from another address book or a spreadsheet into Google Contacts. I hope you found this to be useful. If you have other questions for me, please drop me an email. There's contact information on our website, and I will do my best to answer all the questions from you, because that's what I'm all about, is answering the questions. Hope you found this useful. Please subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to give us a like if you've liked the video. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.